The charity that built Australia's first care facility for young people plans to build a lot more. And Young Care is using thongs to pay for them. This Friday is National Thong Day, and we're all being encouraged to wear our pluggers for a good cause.
It's one of life's simple pleasures. But singing is something Tim Martin doesn't take for granted. 7 years ago, the then university student couldn't speak after suffering a brain injury that changed his life.
A mystery. I don't know.
His right side is paralysed. Slowly, he's learning how to walk and talk again.
Putting my 23-year-old brother into an old people's nursing home for the rest of his life was not an option.
Instead, Tim Martin lives in a young care unit, purpose-built accommodation with around-the-clock care.
Freedom, really. Party all night long.
He can rock away to Powderfinger, to Year 2, and an old people's nursing home, he couldn't do that.
More than 6,500 young people live in aged care, where the average age is 86. The average life expectancy, just 3 years.
And it's not appropriate for them to be surrounded by people who are dying. It's an incredibly depressing environment to be in.
MS sufferer Sharon Ball experienced that firsthand. Now she runs a business from home.
I wasn't seeing, speaking, anything, whereas now I'm doing all that. So I'm just pushing forward all the time.
Young Care plans to build more facilities across Australia. This Friday, it's holding National Thong Day to raise money. Anyone who can help should go to www.thongday.com.au. Sarah Horsley, 10 News.